Hi, Fofamon here. Want to have real-time face tracking like this? And full body motion capture like this? In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can get your avatar set up like this for less than $100. This video is brought to you by Private Internet Access. Enjoy fast, secure web browsing from any country in the world. Click in the video description to learn more. Okay, I know I said at the beginning of the video, $100. So let me be completely transparent now, is that that $100 price range was assuming that as a VTuber, you would have some things. So I'm assuming that one, you already have an iPhone with Face ID and that you already have a VR headset. Where does that $100 come from? Essentially, it comes from two applications, which we will talk about in a moment. Before we dive into it, let's talk about what's currently on the market. Currently, there is one application that has the potential to have real-time face tracking, and that application is called VC Face, which I've actually talked about in two previous videos before, which you can see right over there. I'll also make sure that I have those videos linked in the video description down below. Now, the most common VTuber application that you see most people use is something called Luppet, which is a program that I've actually used quite extensively. However, it has very limited face tracking, and essentially it's limited to eyes open and mouth open and eyes closed and mouth closed. One stipulation in order to get the best quality tracking performance out of that application is you need to have a pretty decent camera. At the very minimum, you need to have a Logitech C920 with excellent lighting. So let's talk a little bit more about that $100 price. I will note that it is possible to do this with the Unreal Engine with their free application called Live Link Face, negating the need to paying for the application called FaceCap, which we're going to be mentioning later. However, my experience using Live Link Face is that it's not as refined or as accurate as FaceCap. And also the Unreal Engine is a little bit harder to master and even compile an application that would be usable for most VTubers. So what are you going to need to get started? I'm going to make sure that I have links to everything in the video description down below. So let's start off with the two things that are actually going to cost you money. So the very first one and the most expensive one is the iOS application called FaceCap. FaceCap is the application that you can use on your iPhone with Face ID that allows you to have the real-time face tracking that you're seeing right here. And what's really, really nice about it is that you can try it completely free before paying any money. The next paid application is Virtual Motion Capture, which is also available for free. But if you want to be able to have this kind of motion capture ability sent to other applications like what we're going to be using today, you do need to have the Patreon version, which at minimum is going to cost you $3. You're going to need a VR headset with two controllers. My most recommended setup is actually having one tracker for your head and two index controllers so you can actually get full finger tracking. If you want to be able to have full body motion capture in addition to the face tracking, then you're also going to need to invest in three additional trackers, one for your waist and one for each feet. You're going to need Unity 2019 311F1, UniVR RAM 0.57.1_60A9. Like I said, the links are going to be down in the video description. You're going to need external receiver pack, VRM4U, Blender, CATS plugin, virtual motion capture, the Patreon version, FaceCap, which I mentioned before, and your avatar. Now, what's very important is you actually use the same versions of Unity and UniVRM that I mentioned or linked in the video description down below. I have not had success using any other version. So first thing you're gonna do is bring your avatar into Blender. And honestly, this is the most difficult part and time-consuming part of the whole entire process. What you're gonna need to do is select the mesh of your avatar, then go into the blend shape slash shape key section of your avatar. And essentially what you're gonna do is create around 50 different blend shapes for your facial expressions. Now, these blend shapes are very specific blend shapes that the Apple AR kit can detect. How I did it is I opened the reference images provided by Apple, links in the video description, and then I created a blend shape, named it exactly the same as the Apple AR kit blend shape name, and I did my very best to manipulate my avatar's mesh to match that same blend shape expression. It's very, very important that you use the exact same naming scheme as Apple AR Kit's documentation recommends. Once you finish adding all of your blend shapes, you're gonna export your avatar using CATS plugin as you would normally if you were creating any other avatar for an application like VRChat. Next, download and install Unity 2019 3.11 F1 and install these plugins. Then, import your avatar and convert it to VRM. For a more detailed guide on how to do this, I actually made a video on this previously, so you can see this video right here. You can completely skip the regular VRM iLook setup and blend shape setup, but what you will need to do is make sure that you do use the VRM MTune shaders and you use the VRM Spring Bones if you wanna have any kind of physics or movement with your avatar, like in terms of hair movement. Next, you're gonna add the external receiver pack to your hierarchy, then select it. Then in the inspector, you're gonna look for and choose your VRM avatar that we just converted, and make sure that if for some reason you're using a different VRM model that already has like some of the iLook enabled, make sure that you disable the blend shape information option. Next, selecting your avatar, you're gonna go to add component in the inspector and add FaceCap OSC receiver, then select the body of your VRM avatar as the avatar that's gonna be receiving the face blend shape information. Now we're gonna go to virtual motion capture. Go to the settings in virtual motion capture, and then here is where the Patreon version really comes in handy. This is where you're gonna see OSC, and you're gonna set the IP address to your local host as seen here, and make sure that the port number matches the external receiver pack port number in Unity. Then you're gonna import the very same VRM avatar into virtual motion capture and hit calibrate. Now on your iPhone, make sure that it is connected to the exact same network as your computer, then go to the App Store and open FaceCap. Here is where you're gonna be able to test out your facial motion capture before you actually dive in and make the purchase for the application. Now in Unity, press the play button. And the first thing that you should notice is that now your avatar has the matched movement to what it has in virtual motion capture. Then in the iOS app FaceCap, hit the go live button. Since you're using the unpaid version, you're gonna see your face activate for maybe a few seconds and it's gonna start tracking your face. Then after a few seconds, it's going to deactivate. Just kind of use this as a testing process. So for me personally, I had to go back into Blender and adjust a lot of the face blend shapes to get them exactly the way I wanted. Now, once you have everything set up, one thing that you should do is move the camera location, as well as you can change the background color. And when you get everything set up exactly the way you want it, you're just about finished. So go to File, Build and Publish, and your application should launch and you should have a separate standalone application like I have right here. Now, I know this video had a lot of information in it, but I do stream regularly on Twitch with a game called VRChat, and you'll actually be able to see me use this in action, usually on my stream. And if you have any questions, feel free to pop in and say hello.